It's a very deep topic, and
okay,
we could probably speak for this for days. But let me kind of start out with that. There's different viral loops, as I call it, and you can build virality into a product in different ways. And typically, you will do that by creating a loop. And how a loop works, just briefly. So imagine something like LinkedIn here. So when you are becoming a new user on LinkedIn, one of the first things that LinkedIn wants you to do is to invite your friends. So I have set up my LinkedIn profile and I've kind of filled out my CV and everything. And then they are basically prompting me, oh, you have no people in your network. Why not invite someone? And typically what they did in the beginning here was that they wanted you to import your address book. So when I signed up for LinkedIn, they prompted me to invite my friends or my colleagues to LinkedIn. And then of course, what happened was that the people that I invited, some of the people that got my invitation, they also ended up signing up for LinkedIn. And when they signed up for LinkedIn, then they were also prompted to invite their network. And then of course, they invited their network. Some of those people also ended up signing up and they also got prompted to invite their network. And then it basically spins like a loop.
Right.
So that's kind of like how virality is made. There's a method to build these type of loops. And there's, in my opinion, 5 different things that you have to have in place. But kind of like just to get started here. So virality can also be divided into different way of thinking of virality. One of them is word of mouth. Another one is incentivized. That you can incentivize people like with LinkedIn. Another one is casual contact. That's something like the Hotmail example, where people can kind of see this was made with Hotmail in the button of an email. And there's also organic. And I mean, you have to be deeply understanding your product and your users and kind of like maybe also even looking at what are your competitors doing in order for you to build loops, the right rival loops. But the thing is not building the loops. The thing is actually understanding how to improve upon them. So what you need to understand here is that, let's say something like LinkedIn. So they have a conversion rate on signing up. A percentage of the people who sign up to LinkedIn also end up inviting their users or their friends, colleagues. A percentage of the people that is invited. So let's say I invite 100 people. A percentage of those people are also converting. And then of course, when I have sent out this email, a percentage of the people who sees this email will go to the landing page. A percentage of those people who come to the landing page will also, I mean, will sign up as well. And a percentage of those people will then invite their network. But you have to understand all the different metrics and you have to understand the funnel here in order for you to optimize it. So let's say in the LinkedIn example here, I can optimize the landing pages. So there's multiple different landing pages that my audience is seeing here. And there's also multiple different emails that they're seeing. And the pop-up that they're seeing is also different. And I want to make the incentive the incentive way better. So what are they actually getting out of inviting these people? I need to optimize on all these different things, and you can work on your copy, you can work on the visuals and all of these different things. And that is how you win. It's easy to set up a viral loop, in my opinion, but you have to understand all the different factors going into how you can make it a great loop. And then you have to optimize on all of these different things and make your viral loop better than the other ones. So it's not about, you could say, just creating it. It's about how you improve it.